Welcome to this video from In 28 Minutes. Thanks for helping us provide awesome learning experiences to more than 300,000 learners across multiple platforms, Udemy, Safari, and Pact. Let's welcome our lead instructor, Rangarao Karanam. In this video, we would be talking about Spring Batch Framework. What is Spring Batch? Spring Batch is a lightweight framework helping you to develop great batch applications. Batch applications are very, very important in enterprises. There are a lot of things that you would want to do in the backend. You would want to process data. Maybe you would want to calculate stuff. Or you might want to take the data from a specific system and process it and put it in some other system. There are a wide variety of reasons why you might need batch programs. And the requirements of all these batch programs are very, very similar. For example, restartability. You'd want to start a batch program from where it failed. You'd want to be able to talk to a database. You might want to talk to an external system to read the data from. And you'd want to be able to write them back a similar way. You might want to write to a database and stuff. So Spring Batch provides a different set of readers and writers which enable you to do that. You might want to process things in chunks. So if I have 1 million records to process, probably you can start processing them 1,000 at a time. So that even if something fails, only those 1,000 are failing. You can continue processing all the rest of this stuff. Transaction management is one of the very important things that you would want when you are using a batch program. Chunk processing makes it very, very easy. And also, you can do parallel processing. It makes it very easy to run these chunks in parallel. All the different steps that are part of the Spring Batch program can be run in parallel, very, very easy. What are the important things that are part of the Spring Batch? How can you write a Spring Batch program? A Spring Batch program is nothing but a sequence of steps. So you can create a number of steps where you can configure what is the next step to run, as part of the step, what needs to be done, and you can configure a decision. This step needs to be run only in these situations. And you have the concept of a job launcher, which is used to launch the job. Whenever you create a new job, it is called a job instance, and it's provided with a unique ID, which can be used to restart the job. So a typical job would look like something like this. So you have a job, you have series of steps, and sometimes you can also split this step into multiple flows. So these are run in parallel. So this step and these steps are run in parallel. And only when they complete, the step 4 is run. So step 1 is run, step 1 and step 2 and step 3 here are run in parallel. Now, what are the best practices? The best practices that you need to be aware of is be careful about exception handling and transaction management. Whenever you build batch programs, these are the most critical things that you need to talk about. Make sure that the program is deployed as near to your databases and the applications where you have the data as possible. Performance is critical in terms of batch programs, and being near to the data is as important as possible. The other thing is to make sure that you have enough memory. Think about memory. How much memory does your program need, and what's the maximum memory do you have? And make sure that you're actually stress testing from the start. One of the important things about Spring Batch is Spring Batch 3 supports JSR 352. It's a Java specification for batch processing, and Spring Batch 3 supports that. In 28 Minutes is providing awesome learning experiences to 300,000 learners across platforms like Udemy, Safari Online, and Pact. We have clocked million hours of learning in the last few months. The question is, what do you want to learn next? We are building solutions to help programmers at all levels. You can learn programming with our awesome courses on Java, Python, and JavaScript. You can learn full stack development with REST APIs and microservices with a wide range of frameworks like Spring Boot, Node.js, React, Angular, and Spring Cloud. We have 200 plus videos to help you start your journey from a programmer to a software architect. We have videos to help you learn frameworks, industry trends, including things like microservices. Learn the best practices in architecture, design, and code quality. Thanks for watching. Keep learning in 28 minutes.